Hey guys, what's up? It's Charlie here, and today we're going to be looking at what happened to the first monkey in space. When we think of space exploration, humans seem to get all the credit. For example, the first man in space, Yuri Gagarin, is very famous. And the first man on the moon, Neil Armstrong, is even more famous. But before humans ever ventured to space, animals went before them. Well, today we look at the very sad story of a monkey named Ham, who was the first chimp in space. But before we launch off, why not subscribe and press the notification bell too? Ham the space chimpanzee was born in 1957 in the French Cameroons. He was in the wild having a nice, natural chimpanzee life. But sadly, at a very young age, he was captured by animal trappers in Cameroon. He was then sent to the rare bird farm in Miami, Florida, USA. It only took a few months and he was purchased by the US Air Force. He was nicknamed Subject 65, aka Ham, by the US Air Force. Ham being an acronym for the Holloman Aerospace Medical Center. That's because in 1959, he was brought to the Holloman Air Force Base. He was actually one of 40 chimpanzees who had been captured and sold to the US Air Force. These 40 chimps were unwittingly enrolled in what was known as the School for Space Chimps. And if this school had teachers' pets, then Ham was definitely that. Ham was the best chimp in the entire class. He seemed to be much more fit and much more intelligent than all the other chimps. He was comfortable being strapped into his container. According to his trainer and handler, Edward Dittmer, he was wonderful. In a very short space of time, he learned how to push levers and other things. His trainer, Edward, said he was more like a little kid than a chimp as he was so smart. He was also known as Chop Chop Chang, but by 1959, this secret space chimp project had been whittled down to two chimpanzees. It was there that Ham had to do various tests. He did timed tasks in response to electric lights and sounds. For example, he was taught to push a lever within 5 seconds of seeing a flashing blue light. If he failed this task, then he would get an electric shock. But if he got this task right, then he would be given a banana. The real amazing part about Ham's mission was that he was not just simply a passenger going up to space. Instead, he'd actually be manning the spacecraft himself. Ham was also subject to nearly 5 minutes of zero gravity, an experience he did not like. But on the 31st of January 1961, it was Ham's big day. He got dressed in a diaper, waterproof pants, and a spacesuit. He was also fitted with sensors to monitor his heart rate, breathing, and body temperature. He was then put inside a capsule, which was then put inside a Mercury Redstone 2 rocket. The rocket, abbreviated as MR2, was launched from Cape Canaveral, Florida. Then in the early hours of January 31st, it launched. At first, Ham's capsule did suffer a partial loss of pressure. But thankfully, Ham's spacesuit prevented him from suffering any harm. Ham was able to push the lever at the sign of the blue flashing light, just as he did on Earth. Ham then went into orbit and outer space. And when he had to come down, the blue light flashed and he pulled the lever. Ham's capsule then splashed down into the Atlantic Ocean. And then within a few hours, his capsule was found again by a rescue ship. Amazingly, Ham suffered no physical injuries except a bruised nose. And his flight only lasted 16 minutes and 39 seconds. There was actually a video recording Ham during his 16-minute flight. And according to one of the NASA scientists, he said he'd never seen such terror on a chimp's face. This means Ham must have been absolutely petrified and confused when this was going on. But despite this, he was still able to pull the lever and go back to Earth. If he failed to do this, he would have been stuck in space and would have passed away there. It was actually only after the flight that Ham got his name, Ham. That's because the US Air Force feared it would be bad PR if a named chimp passed away in space. That's why he was only called number 65 before his flight. But what happened to the first hominid in space? The first man in space got a motorcade going along the streets of Moscow to the Kremlin. And Neil Armstrong was also given many medals, awards, and even a parade. But sadly, the first primate in space got none of that. After his flight, he lived all alone for 17 years. He lived a lonely life in the National Zoo in Washington, D.C. And in 1983, Ham sadly passed away. His body was then handed over to the Armed Forces Institute of Pathology. They were going to have him stuffed and put on display at the Smithsonian Museum. But after a very negative public reaction, this plan was abandoned. Instead, they removed Ham's bones and buried his remains at the International Space Hall of Fame. You can actually see Ham's grave in New Mexico at the International Space Hall of Fame today. And you can see Ham's skeleton in the National Museum of Health and Medicine. So, sadly, despite being a space hero, Ham lived a lonely life after the mission. But whatever happened to the other chimp that passed the program with Ham? This chimp was nicknamed Minnie, and she never actually went into space. She was only actually going to be used if something went wrong with Ham, which it didn't. Instead, Minnie went on to become part of the Air Force chimpanzee breeding program. She produced 9 children, and she was also the last surviving astro chimpanzee. She died at the ripe old age of 41 on March 14th, 1998. So, Ham is a space hero, and luckily he did survive space. But it sure is sad he was captured by animal trappers in his native Cameroon. And then for 17 years, he had to live a lonely life in the National Zoo. I think at the very least, they could have released him back into the wild. But what's your view on how Ham was treated? Was it good or bad? Make your opinion known in the poll in the top right corner. If you guys want some more amazing videos, then check out my second channel. There will be a link to that on screen in a moment. But as always, thanks for watching, check out some more videos on screen right now, leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.